So this is where I'm at so far. I got a lot of the cross members in. This front end is pretty well secure. I went from the pin kind of crisscross to make sure things were square before I tightened everything up, bolted everything in fast. I still have an issue with this piece right here. This frame, as you can see, it comes out here, and then right here, it makes a turn to go back. Well, this right here is flat. This is perfectly flat. It's right up against the frame. The frame is flat there. This is tight. It leaves this gap here. That's quite a gap. That's 3/8 on the this side of the hole is 3/8. That side of the hole is 1/4 inch. So that's 1/8 of an inch taper pretty much on that. Can I put that in and draw it down? Probably. Is that the right way to do it? Well, probably not, but I actually almost think that's the way it was done from the factory, because I've got another truck out here that is the same thing. You can see where this is a little distorted out there on that, and I'll take you out there in a second. But and I asked a couple of people that are pretty knowledgeable with Brockway trucks, and they said the same thing. They said, yeah, just draw it down, you know. So I don't know so much as if I like that idea. All right, we're gonna use the template. Just wanna make sure the center, you know, this has got some distortion to it, so I use the flatter edges to line it up to get my four bolts in there correctly. And so we can drill this out. Search. Well, there it is. I put them in, torqued them down. And as you can see, it bows that plate right in, but that's apparently the way it's done. Not the best. And it also bows this just slightly. But this section is straight. It doesn't bow till it gets here, but there's going to be some bolts that are going to be tightening this in when I put the steering box in there. So I guess it is what it is. But that's what all the others showed, and that's what the different people I talked to about it. But I don't like it. And in the meantime, while I'm waiting, I'm gonna get this rear cross member. I gotta grind those things out of there that were welded in there. I gotta grind those out so the cross member goes. And but I gotta get it set right because this frame's a little bit different than what this rear cross member come out of the frame section that my air ride came out of for over here. So I gotta re-drill these holes, make it a little wider, I believe, or narrower, I'm sorry. And then I can get this last cross member in. Once that's in, I gotta get my tractor fired up. I can get that other front axle over here. I was originally gonna use the 16,000 pound front axle with the butt hubs, with the wedge brakes, but I've got another axle I can use out of a Ford that will bolt right up to these springs, and it'll give me cam brakes. So, and I don't have to pull the hubs to change the brakes. It's got the outboard drums on it. So, but it is still stud piloted. So that's what I'm gonna do there. So I'm gonna get at it and measure this up and see what I got. There, last cross member is in. So that's not an official Brockway cross member, but it's the one that's gonna be on here. So I had to re-drill some of the holes, and but I got it. So now the cross members and that are all in. And the next thing I've got to do is get that front axle over here, get it sandblasted and painted, and get the front axle in, get the tires on it. So then I can set that on the ground, take these posts, take these things out, set the front axle down on the ground, and then I can roll this forward a little bit. I can get the rear axle and get it in there, and then pull it back up and set that down in. So we're coming along. That's a handy thing to have, to be able to sandblast that. This is a new old stock axle spacer that I got from a guy out in Churchville, New York, Dane Baldwin. He's got a lot of parts for Brockways and stuff, so we're going to go ahead and get some primer on this and then some paint. One thing that's missing on the other side is this pin, and these do come out once in a while, so I've got to make one. I just want to see what the... It's like a 3/4 inch pin. If I measured a hole on, yeah, 3/4 inches. Good. The only thing I got to do is I got to bring you over here. We got to measure the depth of that hole. Boy, I'm not going to be able to do that. See, right here, you can measure the depth. And I don't think I'm going to be able to get this in there to measure the depth of that pin. Son of a gun. So, I'll do it the hillbilly way. So that's 3/4 deep, and then I think it just sticks up. Sticks up just under half. So that's 7/16 above. So it's just under 7/8 of an inch long. That whole pin. It's gotta be longer than that. What the hell did I do? 3/4. 7 there. That's better. It's just a little over an inch long. It's 1 1/16 inches long. Get your math right, buddy boy. Yeah, there we go. So we got 1 3/16 inches. 1 3/16 inches long. So for that pin. So it's 3/4 inch and 3/16. I'm sure I got some round stock. I can turn a piece in the lathe, cut it off, and I'll have a pin. But I think that's pretty hard, so I'll have to use a carbide cutter. And I've got a pin off the old Brockway that is exactly the right size that I need. I just got to part it off, so I got a piece to put down in there, because that's harder than just cold roll, you know, just steel. This is they're a hardened pin. So I'm going to part this off with a grinder as to what I need, put it down in there, and then I'll be golden. But thank God for that old parts Brockway truck that I got that's been working out pretty well. All right, some of the problems you can run into when you're doing this. these spacers are 1 inch thick. That's a standard spacer on here. If you look underneath the spring pack, there's a center bolt that sticks down. That one sticks down 1/2 inch. Okay, so we're good here. If this doesn't stick above this by 1/2 inch, we're golden, which it shouldn't. So that'll be fine. But on the other side, the center bolt has a little deeper head. And what I'm gonna have to do is go in there with a grinding wheel. I'm gonna leave this alone, but let's see if I can get a shot of it there. If you look at that center bolt, that sticks down 5/8 of an inch. It's got a flange on it. It's not a washer, it's a flange. But so I gotta go through there and I gotta knock like 1/8 of an inch off the how far that sticks down in, because that will hit this, you know, in the center of the spacer, and it won't allow that to pull down and to tighten up on the axle. So, hey, just thought I'd mention it. That's, you know, some of the crap you run into when you're restoring the old trucks. You got to be careful, because you start mixing new center bolts with older stuff, and you know, things can change. So you got to measure everything. Yeah, the sun is providing quite a bit of glare here, but anyway, I got the paint on it. So on the spacer, so the other one's painted up. So this is what they had. They had this. Look, I've pointed this out before. You see the difference. I don't know why, but this one, that pin was gone, and it slid around. And if you look, this is wore flat here. This still has the recess. So you can see it. It wore for me. It was been moving around. And that's probably what broke the leaf. And this is cracked almost all the way down in there. I was originally going to mill this down to that thickness, but then when I found out that one was still available as new old stock, I went ahead and had it shipped up. It was here in 2 days. So from where Churchville is to Johnstown. So So that'll be the next project, getting that axle bolted up in there, and then I can start on the wedge brakes.
All right. Gotta cut that pin to the bottom of the underneath the springs there for that spring spacer. Not bad for Harbor Freight things, huh? All right, so now, since I didn't cut that perfectly straight, I think I'm gonna have to go and grind that straight. Oh, dear, 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 dear. But that shouldn't be a big deal. Let me throw that on the bench grinder. All right, so, that's what we gotta have. We gotta have something to mark that with. Short work of that, doesn't it? Why don't I just grab right a hold of that, right? Yeah. Now I'm going to clean that end up, chamfer the end a little bit, and then we'll throw a little paint on it and pop it in place. All right, well, let's see how well this fits in here. Pretty good, actually. I'm gonna throw some paint on it. That fit perfect before. I wonder if the paint's taking up the spot. Well, let's see if we can tap it in. Nice tight fit. Turn it the right way, Jimbo. One thing I do want to recheck. There's this thing over here to make sure I got enough depth to